Hi, welcome to samscotts.co.uk. Today I'm going to take you through a lower back release routine. So it's just three simple exercises. So first, we're going to reset the pelvis by adjusting the glutes and the hip flexors. So we're going to adapt the way the pelvis moves, and then we're going to pop it back into place, which sounds a bit harsh, but it's a really effective way of relieving the lower back. And then finally, what we're going to do is just open up the hips once the hips have been reset. So we start off with a bit of pull and pushing on the thighs and the shins. So we take a seated position and slowly lower yourself, keeping your core engaged. Come to this position, and then from here, you're going to grab your left shin and then put your right hand on your right thigh near the knee, and then basically we're going to push the left leg forwards, we're going to pull the right leg back, and we're going to do that for 6 seconds, resisting the movement of the legs. Then we swap sides, doing the opposite. So pulling and pushing as hard as possible, keeping as much tension in the hips and legs as you can. And swap. Just keep that going, pushing as hard and pulling as hard as possible. Now remember, as you do this, you want to keep your lower back as flat to the floor as possible, keeping your core tight. If you find that the lower back is coming off the floor, maybe you need to put a small towel underneath the lower back there to compress the lower back against the floor. So just keep pulling and pushing, roughly six seconds each time. And then once you've done up to 6 lots each side, then what you're going to do is just bring your face together, place them in between your knees, and then stretch your head back, and then push as hard as you can against your fists, and you should feel a pop go on, which is just the pelvis resetting itself, and that will provide relief to your lower back. Now for some people, there might be a lot of tightness going on there and it might not pop the first time, which means you just have to go through that process a few more times until it does. Now if there's any more pain once you've done that, maybe there's going to be some inflammation there. If it's after 24 hours of feeling that pain, you'll need to ice that for around 20 minutes, 3 times a day, and that will reduce the inflammation in the area and give you some more relief. So, once we've done those two exercises, the final one is just mobilizing the hips. Now, there's many ways of mobilizing the hips, but the one that seems to just help the SI joint, which has a direct impact on your lower back, is this one. So we're just looking to go into a 4-point stance, which is like this. And then all we're going to do is we're going to take the left knee over the right knee, like so. And then just reach out with the leg like this. And you should feel a stretch going on around here. Then we'll come back to the start. We're just going to go for 5 each side. Nice and steady, trying to keep your torso facing the ground. So every time you move, it's nice and controlled. And you just push as far across as you can so that you feel the stretch around your hips. So 2 more left, reaching over, feeling the stretch. 1 more time now. And that should feel really good. So we're going to do the same on the opposite side. So just reaching over to the left hand side, trying to keep the pelvis again parallel to the floor, more so this side, and then coming across. Nice steady breaths throughout. Time. And that's it. So those are the main exercises now.